Welcome back to TECHMIMIC, where you can simply view, imitate, replicate, and get on with your day. If there is a specific issue for which you would like to see a video, please leave a comment. In this video, I will explain how to switch from FreeBSD's default shell to another shell, like Bash or chsh. Switching shells is usually done through the command line, but I will show a mix of the terminal in a desktop manager, in this case KDE, but there are no differences, and on the real command line. I won't explain the differences between the different shells, that's not the purpose of this video, but as almost always, you can change this to your liking in FreeBSD. The default shell is the sh shell. To check what shell you are currently running, one could check the shell variable echo $shell, all in capitals. The file etc shells list all of the currently installed shells on your system. Type cat /etc /shells to view its contents. A lesser known alternative to check the currently active shell is with the ps command. ps -p $. This will show the currently running shell by running the ps or process status command. It shows information about the current process ID of the shell that by default is stored in the variable $$. To install bash, type pkg install bash. You may note that I am using sudo instead of su or switching to the root user completely. If you want a step-by-step instruction on how to do this, a link is in the description of this video for your convenience. After the installation is complete, you can verify the installed version of bash with the command bash --version. And bash is now also added to the file etc shells. To make the change permanent, chsh -s user local bin bash. chsa is the command to permanently change the shell, and the -s option is to indicate the path to the new shell. However, the new shell is not immediately effective. Log out and back in, or restart the computer. To start working with the new shell. Doing the same for chsh is actually very similar. To install chsh, type pkg install chsh. After the installation is complete, you can verify the installed version of chsh with the command chsh --version. And also chsh is added to the list of available shells. To make the change permanent and make chsh your default shell, type chsh -s user local bin chsh. Restart the computer. Because we didn't create any chsh startup files, the Z shell configuration will prompt you to make a selection. In this case, I will select 0 to create the .zshrc file in my home directory, which can be adjusted later. After this selection, you can now enjoy the chsh shell. You will notice that the prompt is not yet set, so it will look different from your bash prompt, but you can now start to tweak it with chsh's enhanced customization options to your liking. And as a last comment, if you want to test out or perform something in a different shell, there is no need to make it permanent with the chsh command if you don't want to. Just invoke the shell through its executable and you will now have an interactive session in that other shell. and once done, just type exit to go back to the earlier shell. That's it, there you have it. I said the word shell an awful lot, but I hope it helped, and if it did, please like the video and keep it up. Until next time, bye!